Hello and welcome to Health Talk. I'm Dr. Manny. We've been telling you for years that brown rice is better for you than white rice. But have you ever heard of black rice? Turns out there are a lot of health benefits and it could be the newest superfood. Joining me now to fill us in is our own medicine hunter, Chris Killam. Welcome.
Happy to be here with you, Manny.
Another superfood.
I think this one actually qualifies,
all right.
You know? I kind of got onto this, even though I knew about black rice and had eaten it, I got onto this a few months ago when I was with some black rice researchers in Thailand. And it turns out that black rice is, it truly is a superfood. Per spoonful, and this is black rice,
Where does it come from?
Well, it comes from Southeast Asia.
Right.
And it used to be called emperor's rice or forbidden rice because only royalty could eat it.
Oh, wow.
It's a rarer rice.
Mm-hmm.
It's not grown in the same quantity as white or red rice.
So the color of black rice, because, you know, when you see regular rice before it has gone through sort of the filtering process,
it
has a cover to it.
Right.
This is genuinely black in color, right?
Well, this actually is hulled as well. The hard hull is removed from it. But it is black or deep purple because it has a group of naturally occurring pigments called anthocyanins. And we've talked about this before. They're in blueberries, they're in cranberries, they're in acai.
Right.
Per spoonful, there are more anthocyanins, these powerful antioxidants, in black rice
now,
than all those others.
Why is it so healthy?
Well, it's healthy for a number of reasons. For people on a gluten-free diet, there's no gluten in it. It's low glycemic, so you eat it, it doesn't spike your blood sugar way up.
Mm-hmm.
It is also, it contains a compound called C3G, or cyanidin-3-glucoside. And this is a blood sugar modifying agent. It's one of the pigments, but it has unusual properties. And its best property, I think, for people who are trying to manage weight is it reduces leptin, the substance in our bodies that makes us hungry.
How does it taste?
Black rice?
Yeah.
You eat this stuff all the time.
I know that. But I got to ask the question for the people that don't eat
it. How does it taste,
It tastes
Manny.
Delicious.
It tastes delicious.
Especially if you put a pork chop next to it.
A little bit nutty. but really, really good.
No, it is very, very good.
And if you eat this black rice, you will not be hungry afterward.
Right.
And that's the great thing. So reducing appetite, and there's something else that it does. It draws upon stored fat in the body,
mm-hmm.
and it draws upon sugar from the blood, so it actually helps to reduce fat weight and sugar in the blood.
Okay. Now, you have there a powder. Is that also?
This is the flour, and you can see this is...
So this is refined, this is grinded...
This has been very finely milled, and actually in this case, this was sprouted and freeze-dried. It's a unique black rice.
But, okay, so I know how to eat that and how to cook that.
Yep.
That's like regular rice. How would I apply this to my diet?
Bake bread with it. We're seeing people make purple bread now out of so-called black rice.
So this flour you can actually bake with?
Yeah, if I gave you a piece of toast or a baked good made with black rice flour, you'd simply say, you know, depending on the recipe, you say, oh, you know, nice bread.
So anybody could benefit from this?
If you've got metabolic syndrome,
right.
if you've got type 2 diabetes, if you're pre-diabetic, if you find that you have an out-of-control appetite, this will be a food that, if you eat it with some regularity...
Now, let's talk about regularity. How often should I put this in my weekly diet?
You know, a few times a week as your primary starch.
So replace potatoes for black rice.
Sure.
Replace
white flour.
White flour,
right.
Like spaghetti or pastas.
Mm-hmm.
Go more for the black rice. Because
mm-hmm.
it's a little expensive, though.
Yeah. By the way, we also know that the ingredients in black rice reduce overall inflammation in the body. And as you know, inflammation is part and parcel of every chronic degenerative disease. So this actually qualifies as a true superfood. It's not just a label slapped on it. This is quite a breakthrough.
Right. Well, listen,
without the pork chop.
Right. But it used to be, I remember because my wife is very much into this because she follows you a lot with your ideas and recipes and everything else. But it used to be rare to find, but now it's available everywhere, right?
We're seeing a lot of rice varieties, like jade rice, the green stuff, red rice from Bhutan, black rice from Thailand and Malaysia. And as this becomes more popular and is cultivated more, I think we'll also see the price go down.
Yeah, yeah. I think it's doing that because there's a lot of competition and it's available everywhere. Okay, so I got the skinny on black rice. Superfood. Good for us.
Superfood, good for us.
It can make us very healthy at the end.
And it can help to control cravings. You know, people really have a hard time. They're overweight. They keep craving food. They eat and eat and eat. If that appetite can be kicked off, they can be liberated somewhat from that
cycle. All right. Yeah. Well, thank you so much.
My pleasure.
People are going to read about black rice where?
Where can they get it?
Yeah.
Well, they
information?
They can read about it on medicinehunter.com. I'm good at picking up cues. You medicinehunter.com.
That's right. Medicinehunter.com. Thank you.
Thank you.
And if you have any health questions, tweet me at Dr. Manny on Fox. Until next time, I'm Dr. Manny.